Oh my God, Santa's here. This changes everything. Thanks for coming out. Here we are, December already. December certainly snuck up on us, didn't it? I'm not someone who even thinks about the holidays until after Thanksgiving, but we began learning about these songs and learning the lyrics all the way back into September. Seems early, and that we would have months to learn them, but I have to remember that I only see the students once a week. There are multiple days off for conferences, professional development days, for teachers' holidays, so the time snuck up on us quickly. We were offered a chance to wait until January to do our winter concert, but growing up, there was a certain feeling, a certain magic in the air I got as a kid, going to the winter concert assemblies, watching the other students perform, and then being one of the performers on stage. So I didn't want to wait until January to sing songs that get us into that holiday spirit. So I thank everybody for coming out tonight. My name is Mr. Pugh. I am your child's vocal music teacher, and we've worked very hard this quarter and half quarter to prepare for this night for you, and I hope you enjoy this one-of-a-kind show.
Smith in 1934. Mr. Smith wrote the song while in a hospital as he was looking at the snow-covered Central Park in Homesdale, Pennsylvania. It had been covered by over 200 different artists. Tonight, we sing our version of the song that we call Pine Grove Wonderland, with lyrics written by Mr. Pugh to get us in Pine Grove winter holiday spirit. It was featured on his CD entitled Rock Music for Education that he recorded along with other educational rock songs back in 2008.
I'm sure you are as well. They work very hard to learn the songs, but most importantly, my goal for your children is to have fun. Enjoy coming to music, learn different styles of music and how traditional songs can be changed and modified. My mom is here tonight, who always sang in our house and is half the reason I have a love of music. She's also who you can blame slash attribute for my fashion sense, as I'm surprised my mother is not wearing a sequined hat or a neck, but she does have a nice sweater there. Thanks, Mom. My son and wife are here tonight. Thank you for your support. I love you. And the nameplate that you see was my father's nameplate when he was an elementary school teacher. Thank you. So he is here with us as well, as he is the other half of the reason I have a love of music. And this next song the Christmas song, is the song that brings me back to my childhood and that warm feeling you get at Christmas. I didn't really realize it until I spent my first Christmas without my father, and this song came on the radio and it brought back such a wave of memories for me. My father would sing this song to me and tell me about musicians like Nat King Cole. This is the album that he would play for us, and play the records of various artists that had Christmas albums. So this is a very, very meaningful song to me. All right.
Interesting to know what it is.
The Christmas song, also known as Chestnuts Roasting on an Open Fire, was written by Meltor Band a hot summer day in July 1945. Yes, that's right. One of the most popular winter songs was written in the middle of summer. On that hot day, Meltor May was trying to think of things to cool off. So he started thinking of chestnuts roasting, Jack Frost sipping, the old time girls, and folks dressed like Eskimos. He didn't think he was writing song lyrics. He said if he could immerse himself in winter, he could cool off. 40 minutes later, a song was written. The most popular version of this song is recorded by Nat King Cole. It took several versions of the song to record it from years 1946 to the year 1961, until Nat King Cole was satisfied with the one we well known, the version we hear today. Tonight's version has some lyrics have been changed to belt inclusive and modernized for all to appreciate and enjoy. Mr. Pugh produced this version using the most sampled drummer from the 1990s, originally created by the Soul Searchers, that also from artists from Billy Vanilli to PM Don and Duran Duran have used.
Thank you.
thank you to everyone coming out tonight to support the music program here, the parents and other supportive grown-ups in our lives, the teachers, Mr. Manzo, Mrs. Richardson. Yes, you can clap for them, yes. Mr. Richardson right over there. And one of my former students, Mrs. Reisinger back there, yes. It's always nice to have a former student be now a co-worker. As always, a big thank you to the administrators. Mrs. Lewis, our principal. There she is. And in case you haven't the pleasure to meet our new assistant principal, Mrs. Edwards is back there as well. I'd also like to give a huge shout out, big shout out to Officer Adam over here. He is a friendly face that comes into our school on a regular basis, and we see him in the hallways, and we see him in the cafeteria playing rock, paper, scissors with the first graders and fifth graders, and it's great to have him around, and it gives us all a sense of comfort to know that Officer Adam is keeping an eye on us, so we appreciate you, Officer Adam. And also a huge thank you to our building crew, Mr. Robert, Miss Brenda, Mr. Richard, and Mr. Rodney. And I promise wherever you guys are, I won't make as big of a mess as I did last year. That mess is saved for the spring concert. And I'd like to give a big thank you to Mr. Messenger. So thank you for his family. Not feeling well tonight, but he put the extra effort in there to come out tonight, so thank you. And I promise you guys will be home for the Patriots-Steelers game as well. All right.
Jingle Bells is one of the best known and most commonly sung by American songs in the world. It was written in 1850 by James Lord Pierpont at Simpson Tavern in Medford, Massachusetts. It was published under the title The One Horse Open Sleigh in September 1857. It has been claimed that it was originally written to be sung by a Sunday school choir for Thanksgiving. Although it has no original connection to Christmas, it became associated with winter and Christmas music in the 1860s and 1870s. It became the first recorded Christmas-related song when it was recorded in 1889 on the Edison cylinder. Jingle Bells is also the first song to broadcast from space. In a Christmas-themed prank by Gemini 6, astronauts Tom Stafford and Wallace Shakira. While in space on December 16, 1965, they sent a report to Mission Control claiming they observed an unidentified object around the North Pole and then began to play Jingle Bells on a tiny harmonica and Jingle Bells they smuggled onto their spaceship. This version that Mr. Pugh produced is what he believes the song would sound like if his favorite band, Green Day, recorded it.
Thank you.
Supposed to meet us. So if they were not in the band or orchestra, you are going to meet them all the way down at the end of the hallway near the gym. And if you were in the orchestra, you're going to meet in the library. And if they were in the band, they will meet you in the library also, all right? So thank you very much for coming out. Oh, thank you, my lovely wife.